Today we're gonna build some gazebos for the butternut squash and spaghetti squash I bought yesterday from up another place. And what we'll need is basically I need my squares, which I have two of them. One for the base I keep my 48 inches, which is my width of the bottom piece. Four 2x2s for the frame, and several, I'm not exactly sure how many yet, of 1x2s for the slats going up the sides. I use 8x1¼ inch wood nails. I need my chop saw, my drill bit, my drill bits is for to drill a hole in the 1x2s, that way when you attach them to the 2x2s they don't split because you're at the edge of the wood and everything. And with that, let's get started. Okay, now that we got all our stuff ready to go, we gotta decide how far apart we want our slats. You can go 12 inches, you can do every 16 inches, every 2 feet. Choice is up to you. How you wanna do it? 16? We're gonna do every 16 inches. And if you look at your tape measure, 16 inches are in red. 16, 32, 48, 64, 80, and of course 96, which is 8 foot. Except for it's perfectly 16 inches. So you need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 slats. Now of course you gotta run up on both of them, so you take your other square or T-handle, what you want to use. This, you can use a T-handle for this project part of it if you want. And you mark across both of them. You can make small marks, you can make long marks, however you really want to do it. I like going all the way across so I can see. Afterwards, the shine's going to paint it anyway, so it doesn't really matter. Let you cover that up. Okay, now I'm marked. Put that square out of the way. Now you want to separate for the bottom feet are 4 feet apart. That's why I use my other square for T-handle. Yeah, square. Put one corner in the four at the 0, 1 at this side. You put the 48 inches, which is 4 feet. And then you even this top up to about 2 feet apart. Then you start by measuring the first one, which I'm gonna put right here. It's gonna be 11 inches. Now you can decide how wide apart you want it by cutting the boards first and laying it up and then screwing it down and then adjusting as you go up. I like doing it each one individually. That way I can get precisely what I want. 11 inches. Now I take my 1x2s, which of course I always do my shopping at Lowe's. It's because it's closest to me. Mark it. 11 inches. Trusty old suit. tall.
Of course.
Safety first. Wear your safety glasses and find your mark. Put your mark there. Not dirty. First cut done.
Now you lay it up there and see what it looks like. Now you can either leave it as is, or you can make it mark it where it matches the angle of the board and make it nice and clear. So I'm going to mark it.
My carpet. Oh, right there. Get it. Okay. Or you can just drill it on there and use a jigsaw later to cut it off. So now we need to get the drill out. And drill bits I have. Just to make the center, do the first hole. Over to your drill bit, and you line the board back up on the corners, the bottom outside corners. Take the screw, and down you go. Now this will keep your board like that. Keep your board straight. Now you go for your second board. You go on down the line, same way. And this one will be 18 3/8. Now you take your board, next, the same board you just cut the first piece off of because it's long enough. Measure 18 3/8, which is right there. Mark it. Don't lose your Sharpie. And go back over to your saw. Cut it. Change back to the drill bit. If you line it up, Now you should be stable. And now you do three more the same way. And measure the next one.
I built one before with slats were more like a real thin boards for smaller stuff that would hold, I thought would hold it, but they're a little flimsier than I like. So I'm back using 1x2s for everything. It's more sturdy, it'll hold up anything.
Back to the saw. This part of it you can pretty much do by yourself, but when you try to attach the two pieces, you'll need help. Someone to hold it together for a minute while you start the first couple pieces. And after that, you'll be all good to go. Plus, you'll probably need a ladder, so once you stand it up, I'm too short to get the top pieces.
Thank you. Now for the last board, which is 41 and a quarter, got a new board. Okay, the last board from the attached. Now, it'll be good. I'm not going to put this on the base bed. So make sure you have the first mat is above. Tight the dirt. Pull the base bed out. The mid 12 inches, other than you want to be 16, 24, the first mat. Then from there, climb up. And do the dirty stuff and turn it around. Me and you pull the bed. You know what you're going to do. It's squash, so. And we're probably going to make bed. Make it better. If not, I'm going to go up and grab one up. And you see, this is the side of this. It should be like this, with the other side. And go back to next. And I go back on that, and I'll be the next year. Okay, now that we got both sides done, we set it up where you got the 4 feet on each side and they're touching the top like that. Then you measure, now you're gonna need to attach the two sides together. So now we gotta measure this way, which is 18 and a half for our first cut. Let's see if we can make 18 and a half. Oh, it's short. If you need help and you have sort of hold it together while you're starting the process of attaching it to the side. If you had two drills, you could have one with the drill bit in it and one with the screw bit in it, but I only have my one drill. Maybe for Christmas, maybe Father's Day, they can give me another drill. And I'll have two.
Three. That's what you just start impact from.
Well, this is not an impact. Yeah, it is. I got it. I like this one better though.
I know.
It's lightweight, it's easy to use. Let's set my screws in here real quick.
Hold it up here, line it up where we want it.
Goes the shoes.
That's why it's that one. that new bumper squeeze.
Yep.
Name it two inch rows. Be right back. I'm back.
Let's get these ones out. A little too short because of the size. The rules went a little bit longer. I have two pieces on now, one on the back side, one on the front side. It should hold it stable enough where I can work by myself and Cheyenne can work the camera again. So now I'm going to do my top piece and line it up so it's even on both sides and finish my way down on both sides. And when I'm done, we'll show you what the final looks like. Okay, right now I'm going to do the top piece first. Next, I got to about angle it where I want it. Make it even on both all four pieces. Then I measure across, which is 5 inches. That way I'll get my top piece centered.
6 inches. That'll work. Put this one down.
And I measure. I use one scrap, much small pieces as possible. That way you don't waste wood. And this one's 6 pieces. Scrap piece is 6, all I need is 5, so I'll mark it, cut it, and I'll use it up there. I keep using all the small pieces up as much as possible so I don't waste wood. I use my wood on other projects that I have cut that I know Cheyenne had coming up for me. Okay, and then I'm going to attach the top piece, get it all, try to keep it even out on top. Okay, get a little closer. That's why you don't put things on top of your ladder. Drop it. Okay, Cheyenne, I'm going to need your help for a second. Yeah. Put down your lemonade, nice, cold, breezy, looking delicious lemonade you're going to get me for me.
I don't want
your
lemonade,
are you crazy? Okay, you need to hold it right about like that. Down a little bit.
You adjust, I'm gonna hold it.
Hold it off.
Okay,
I'm gonna
a Sharpie. I'm gonna drill bit.
You want me to let
actually,
go?
I think I do have my drill bit. Went the wrong way. Before. Get the first top piece, it goes a little faster. You get the angle, get everything situated right. One screw in. Get a hole. Now I'll do the other one on top side, on the other side, then I'll work my way down. But everything else is similar. Now, also this little gap on top, I set purposely. That way I put a night, we get these little globes, sunlight.
Solar light,
thank you. That way you sit them there and at nighttime it glows and you can see around and it makes it look real pretty after it's painted white. Down the boards. That's what you gotta do. Okay. As you can see, this is my last piece I need to add to my arbor. Screw it in one side. Put it where you want it on the second other side. Screw it in. And now you have a nice sturdy arbor to grow plants on. You can grow roses, you can grow vegetables. Pretty much any kind of plant should hold up pretty sturdy with that. The only thing left to do now is for Cheyenne to paint it and then install it in the garden. This is one that we've already painted. It's pretty much the same thing, 2x2s, 1x2s, they both same way. And as you can see on top, like I said, the gap sits perfectly for the little ball for the solar light. And at night time, when the sun goes down, you can see a little light out of the garden. And you can see your way around and everything. And then basically I get these painted, set it around your raised bed, then you put cucumbers on the side, which this has, and then you leave them in the garden a little bit. And with that, have a blessed day.
But no, you ditched me. No, no fate, best actress in the
supporting role.